If you know how to make money fast in GTA Online, then you already have an advantage over your rivals, because amassing a fortune is absolutely key to progressing in Rockstar's online world. Whether you're looking to purchase the freshest vehicles and weapons, or expanding your criminal enterprise options by investing in additional properties, there are many ways that you can splash your cash across Los Santos and beyond. We appreciate that time is important to you, which is why it's worth bearing in mind that some of the ways to make money fast in GTA Online are considerably more lucrative and efficient than others. And with the number of choices available, it can be difficult to know where you should best invest your efforts to receive the maximum return. In this video guide, we'll steer you in the right direction, outlining the potential profit for each endeavor along with a description of the work involved to achieve it, so you can decide which method works best for you. Welcome back to Gaming Daily Input. Lay back and enjoy, because in today's video, we bring you the best ways you can make money in GTA 5 Online. Before beginning the video, make sure you're subscribed to our channel, Gaming Daily Input, so that you never miss any of our exciting GTA 5 videos. So without further ado, let us begin. Also, at the end of this video, I'm going to announce the winner of the free GTA 5 giveaway. So stay tuned till the end. Now let's begin. Number 10, air freight cargo and nightclubs. Profit depends on your luck and performance. Air freight cargo is basically a less profitable version of special cargo. You'll be better off, from a purely money-making perspective, not investing in these businesses, and instead focusing on what has already been mentioned. However, if you're finding yourself getting bored, then these are some other options to try to keep things fresh. Ultimately, enjoying the game should be a priority, and if making money starts feeling like more of a job, then maybe it's not worth the effort. Always be mindful of why you're grinding for money, and what enjoyment you're taking from the process. Number 9. Selling cars. Profit depends on your luck and performance. Los Santos Customs mod shops will purchase non-track cars, basically any car you haven't claimed for yourself, for small but solid prices. Driving a jacked car to a nearby mod shop will garner a little extra spending money. But keep in mind that cops are always on the lookout for stolen cars, and you can only sell one car per in-game day, 48 minutes. But the rewards can be substantial, depending on the car. SUVs bring in fairly good prices, ranging from 3.5 to 7K. Baller is worth 9K. Lampadetti Felons sell for more than 9K. For more information, view best-selling cars. The math appears to be that the mod shop sale price is 10% of any vehicle's actual purchase price. The Richmond area is probably one of the best places to prowl for high-end but sellable cars. Simeon also has a varying wish list of high-priced rides. He will text you a list of cars he desires. If you happen upon one of these, take it to a mod shop, respray it, then drive it down to the docks. Bring them to him, and you'll garner a decent reward, approximately 2 times what a mod shop would offer, depending on the condition of the vehicle. Really, it's worth it even if you are left stranded at the docks. Number 8. Robberies. Profit depends on your luck and performance. While the amount of cash you'll earn is relatively small compared to other activities, robberies take almost no time at all. GTA Online robberies are similar to GTA 5 robberies. Step into one of the many stores around San Andreas, gas stations, convenience stores, etc., then point a gun at the clerk, grab the money, and flee before the cops arrive. In Grand Theft Auto Online, however, there are a few twists. First, yelling at the cashier, into your microphone, causes them to load money more quickly, but the noise may be overheard by other players, who may choose to lie in wait and kill you to steal your score. Additionally, robberies may be carried out alongside other players, and the person handling the bag of money will be responsible for divvying up the cash when the robbery is over. To divide the earnings, bring up the Quick Interactions menu. From there, head to Inventory, then cash. After this, click the split option and divide the money amongst the participants. Note that cuts are based on percentages and not dollar amounts for ease of calculation. Number 7, survival matches. Potential profits, 20k per match. Survival matches unlock at level 15 and are a great way to earn cash. Successfully making it to the end of the level 10, normally takes less than 10 minutes, pays out 20,000 GTA dollars. These survival missions are anywhere from 1 to 4 players, and fairly simple to beat if you work as a team. The Plain Boneyard map has a building that you can climb onto the roof of that gives you a pretty big advantage. You can replay these as many times as you like and rake in the dough. Jobs create a cycle of increasing returns, growing in value as you grow in experience. Supplement competitive jobs with occasional missions to keep opening up new options. Several multiplayer cooperative mission-type jobs provide substantial cash rewards to ambitious players. Keep in mind that any jobs you replay give you only half as much of a payout as when you first completed them. Number 6, the Lucky Wheel. Potential profits, 20 to 50k per day. Ever since the release of the Diamond Casino and Resort, players have had access to the Lucky Wheel. Each day, no daily reset time, simply a 24-hour cooldown, players can head into the Diamond Casino and approach both the cashier and the Lucky Wheel. While this won't be a reliable source of income, the potential payouts are hefty enough to warrant taking your free spin every day. The cashier will give the player 1,000 chips as a visitor bonus each day, which can be exchanged for 1,000 GTA dollars, while the Lucky Wheel spin can award 2,500 to 15,000 RP, 10,000 to 25,000 chips, and 20,000 to 50,000 GTA dollars. Additionally, you can win mystery prizes, clothing items, and high-end vehicles, whichever vehicle is currently displayed on the rotating podium. Enjoying this video? If yes, make sure you leave a like in this video. Number 5, time trials. Potential profits, 50k per hour. These free roam races against the clock can be quite good money makers if you're good at them. In the same vein as VIP work, each week you'll be able to do a new time trial in between other money making activities and take home a one-off payout of 50k for a few minutes of driving. Some can be quite tricky though, so looking up guides online for whichever time trial is active that week will be helpful. As soon as you start spending over 10 minutes trying to complete one of these, your profit margins dip, and you'd have been better off doing something else with your time. Number 4, gun running or motorcycle club. Potential profits, 80k per hour. Whilst those potential profit values may not sound wonderful, the beauty of these businesses is that they make money passively. That means they'll be producing products for you to sell at a profit while you're making money elsewhere. Buy a bunker for GTA online gun running or a motorcycle club and cocaine business to maximize your profits with these passive methods. Buy your steel supplies for your business and it will convert those supplies into products to sell at a profit when you're ready to do so. If you actually buy supplies, which is often the best strategy from a money versus time perspective, the only input you'll need to do to get your profits is to sell your accumulated product via a mission when it's ready. Be careful though, if you leave things too long, your stock will grow to the point where the sell mission will require multiple people. So if you're a solo player, selling frequently is the best strategy. Number 3, VIP work. Potential profits, 150k per hour. Speaking of when the timer allows, if you're planning to go really hardcore with the money grinding, then you'll want to maximize your playing time. That's where VIP work comes in. Once you start an organization as a VIP or CEO from the interaction menu, you can select VIP work and choose from a number of free roam missions to complete. These are a great way to fill in time between vehicle exports, for example, and will bump up your hourly earnings. They won't give you the same profit as other methods if all you do is focus on these, but they're still solid filler jobs. Headhunter, hostile takeover, and sightseer are notable missions to try. Number 2, special and vehicle cargo. Potential profits, 300k per hour. These two methods have the potential to net the solo player the most money per hour whilst doing other tasks in between jobs. They both require you to have an office building and vehicle warehouses, which can be substantial outgoings. But if you focus on these two aspects, you'll make your investment back relatively quickly. For vehicle cargo specifically, you'll want to source vehicles to fill your warehouse with all 10 unique standards and mid-range cars with no duplicates, so that every source mission you do after that will result in a top-range car. From that point on, you simply continually export a top-range car and source another one, ready to be exported when the timer allows. Number 1. Heists. Potential profits, $400,000 per hour. If you have three friends and one of you has a high-end apartment, heists are the best way to make money, specifically the Pacific Standard Heist. You'll need to make sure you're all of a high enough skill level to be able to complete the missions as efficiently as possible. But if you can get things done without messing around, then your bank balance will quickly increase. The Doomsday Heists are a good option if there are only two or three of you, but require a higher initial cost as you have to buy a more expensive facility to start with. Again, though, you'll make a lot of money if you get through these heists as efficiently as possible. Online guides and some friends who want the same goals as you will help you here. Remember that the latest GTA Online Cayo Perico heist can be completed solo if you don't have anyone to work with. And with that, we bring an end to our video on the best ways you can make fast money in GTA 5 Online. Check out the other GTA 5 mods video as well. The link is in the description. We hope that the video was informative and interesting. Thank you everyone who participated in our giveaway in the last video. Good luck to everyone who participated. And now, we would like to congratulate Wiki Singh, who is the winner of the free GTA 5 giveaway. Don't forget to comment down your contact details to get your free GTA 5. Better luck to all the participants, because there is a lot more to come. Thank you so much for watching to the end. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel, Gaming Daily Input, for more videos like this and to keep yourself updated in the gaming world.